In these examples, we're given the formula for the sequence, and we're asked to determine if the sequence is arithmetic, geometric, or neither. Just to review, remember if we have an arithmetic sequence, then the pattern defined consecutive terms would be to add a constant, or we can say that consecutive terms have a common difference given by this formula here, where d is equal to a sub n minus a sub n minus 1, which means if we select two consecutive terms and we subtract the first term from the second term, we should always have a common difference d. A sequence is geometric if the pattern is that we multiply by a constant to determine consecutive terms, or if we select two consecutive terms, the sequence would have a common ratio, r, given by this formula here, where r is equal to a sub n divided by a sub n minus 1, meaning if we select two terms in the sequence and we divide the second term by the first term, r should always be the same. So for these examples, even though it is possible to tell whether a sequence is arithmetic, geometric, or neither by the form of the formula, let's go ahead and generate several of the terms in each sequence. So for a sub n equals 5 minus 2n, the first term is a sub 1, so n is equal to 1, so we'd have 5 minus 2, that's 3. The second term, a sub 2, so n is 2, we'd have 5 minus 4, that's 1. For the third term, n is 3, we'd have 5 minus 6, that's negative 1. For the fourth term, n is 4, we'd have 5 minus 8, that's negative 3. Let's go ahead and find one more. For the fifth term, n is 5, we'd have 5 minus 10, which is negative 5. So if we can analyze the sequence to determine a common difference or common ratio, we can determine whether the sequence is arithmetic, geometric, or neither. Notice how the terms are decreasing by 2 each time, which means we're subtracting 2 each time or adding negative 2. 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. 1 minus 2 is equal to negative 1. Negative 1 minus 2 is equal to negative 3, and so on, which means we have a common difference d equal to negative 2, and therefore this is an arithmetic sequence. If we're not able to see the pattern in the sequence, we can always use our formulas for d and r to see whether the sequence is arithmetic or geometric. For example, if we select these two terms, notice how d would be equal to 1 minus 3, which is equal to negative 2. Now this isn't enough information to tell us this would be an arithmetic sequence. We'd also want to test two other consecutive terms. So for example, if we select negative 1 and negative 3, the common difference would be negative 3 minus negative 1, which becomes plus 1, and therefore d is still negative 2. And from this information, we can conclude we have a common difference and therefore an arithmetic sequence. Notice if we tested for a common ratio using 3 and 1, we'd have 1 divided by 3, which is 1/3. But then if we found the common ratio using these two terms, we'd have negative 3 divided by negative 1, which is positive 3. And since the ratios are not the same, this is not geometric. Let's take a look at our second example. Again, we'll start by determining several terms in the sequence. Notice when n is 1, we'd have 3 to the first, which is 3 times 2, that's 6. When n is 2, we'd have 3 squared, that's 9 times 2, that's 18. When n is 3, we'd have 3 to the third, which is 27 times 2, that's 54. And then when n is 4, we'd have 3 to the fourth, that's 81 times 2, 162. And so on. Before relying on the formulas, let's see if we can recognize a pattern in the sequence. Hopefully we can recognize that 6 times 3 is equal to 18. 18 times 3 is equal to 54. 54 times 3 is equal to 162. And since we're multiplying by a constant, that means our common ratio is equal to positive 3, and therefore we have a geometric sequence. Again, if we're not able to recognize the pattern by analyzing the sequence, we can test to see whether we have a common difference d or a common ratio r using consecutive terms in the sequence. So if we want to test for a common ratio r, let's go ahead and select these first two terms. So r would be equal to the second term divided by the first term. 18 divided by 6 is equal to 3. Again, if we don't recognize the pattern, this is not enough information to determine that we have a common ratio. We'd also want to select two other consecutive terms. So let's go ahead and select the second and third term. So R would be equal to 54 divided by 18, which is equal to 3. So from here we can see that we have a common ratio, concluding we have a geometric sequence. I also want to point out, if we look at the formula here, notice as n increases by 1, we would multiply it by another factor of 3, which is another way to recognize that we're multiplying by a constant of 3 each time to determine consecutive terms, and therefore we have a geometric sequence. Now for the last sequence, notice when n is equal to 1, we'd have 3 over 3, which would simplify to 1, but since we're looking for a pattern, let's go ahead and leave it as 3 over 3. When n is 2, we'd have 3/4. When n is 3, we'd have 3/5. When n is 4, we have 3/6, which does simplify. We're going to leave it as 3/6. And now by analyzing the sequence, hopefully we recognize that to find consecutive terms, we can't just add a constant because the denominator is increasing by 1, but the numerator is staying the same. We also cannot multiply by a constant to determine consecutive terms, which means this is not arithmetic because we don't have a common difference. It's not geometric because we don't have a common ratio. Again, we could calculate these for consecutive terms, but we should be able to recognize that this is neither arithmetic or geometric by analyzing the sequence. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.